This is it. We're just like 10-ish days away from.
Okay, look at you. Prim-
or look at me. Okay. Just a few days away from the primary. Just how are you feeling? Just how has this whole ride been the past few months?
Oh my gosh, I am feeling so excited about the election. We are 9 days away. I'm so surprised and delighted with the outcome of the of our campaign. We're building so much momentum. There are more signs and mostly people saying they support us, and we started from nothing, and now I feel very confident that we're going to make it into the runoff in November.
And just how do you feel about the way that you ran the election along with the voters? I feel like you've been very quiet and very effective. No, nothing.
Yeah.
Nothing controversial. Good old grassroots work.
I mean, look, this campaign is not about my opponents. It's about folks getting to know me and uplifting the work that our community is already doing. And it's really about grassroots organizing. That's the root of this campaign. And it's really been more positive and connecting with folks, and that's really why people are invested and committed and supporting us.
And of course, yeah, just the connecting with folks part. I guess all the other candidates I've spoken to, they've told me it was the most enjoyable and also very inspiring. Just what have you learned talking to the constituents of the district and just campaigning and talking to folks?
Oh my gosh, I've learned so much on the campaign trail, talking to so many different people, and you know, finding out the parts of this district that have absolutely like been neglected. You know, people who pay taxes and also just their curbs aren't getting repaired or their trees not getting trimmed, but also, you know, so much apathy and people being so disappointed in politics and government. And me talking to them and being the first person that has ever knocked on their door or candidate running for city council. And when I speak with them and I can give them a little bit of faith in me or hope in our process that we can change it, that has been one of the greatest gifts, knocking door to door and meeting folks. Yeah.
Okay, and I guess you can look at the camera for this one. I guess what's your message to folks? I know a lot of people got their ballots and the voting centers opened up the other day also.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, what is your message?
My message is vote Ysabel Jurado for City Council District 14. We're on the first page, third bubble. You know, we got to keep up the fight and make sure you vote by mail or go to the voting centers. Kaya natin, galing sa atin, para sa atin.
Nice. And I guess most of all, I guess maybe are thinking, why is it important and how historic is it to vote for you as well?
Yeah, this is a historic moment. We're following up on the heels of electing our first Filipino citywide elected Kenneth Mejia. I would be the first Filipino council member in Los Angeles history. This is so exciting to have that kind of representation for our community.
Yeah. Well, I guess, you know, this also reminds me. I didn't realize, but this little corner, apparently, it's the Filipino corner. If Jed in 41,
yep,
and I guess this overlaps with Jessica's 52, and of course, your council CD 14.
Just,
I guess how big is it to have possibly three Filipinos representing this region? And it's a pretty Filipino region when you think about it.
Yeah, the fact that we're like the second largest Asian population in the county, Filipinos represent so much, and we've been integrated in other people of color movements. To have us actually represented at different levels of government means that our struggles and our needs may finally be addressed in a cohesive manner, you know? And so it's so exciting to finally see us up there, you know, following Kuya Rob, Rob Bonta, you know, being the AG. It shows that we can do this and we can all fight together.
Awesome.
Thank you.